Hey everybody, Tom Sparks with Sparks Media Group. Today we're going to do what some would consider the unthinkable. We're going to take apart the Matterport Pro 3 camera. You may ask yourself, why on earth would you want to take apart a brand new Pro 3 camera? Well, I'm just curious. If you've seen my previous videos, I've taken apart a Matterport Pro 2 camera, and when I received this, I was curious to see what was inside of it. Now I'll say before you begin this, I'm like 100% sure that it will void any warranties that you have by taking it apart. So do so at your own risk. Some of the methods that I use to get this apart you may not agree with, but just know that I filmed this video in real time. I was kind of stumbling through it, and you'll hear that in my expressions and how I'm talking about things. I'm more focused on not breaking the particular components than I am on narrating exactly what I'm doing. But I'm going to leave everything in so that you guys can see from start to finish how to take it apart and then how to put it back together. So let's begin. This is a camera that Matterport just released not too long ago, and I'll show you guys all the sides of it. And we're going to start by trying to tackle this back plate here. So I have a just a plastic trim removal tool. I'm going to try to get it in here and pop this out and see what happens. Having some success up top. Now there's a rubber gasket that I can see in here, so it's somewhat weather sealed, which is good to know. In here you can see this rubber gasket, and I'm going to flip this around so I can see it, but there's a ribbon cable that's connected. It's right here. So normally with these ribbon cables, you push forward a little bit, and it should slide out. So that's how this ribbon cable comes out. This just is a hinge right here. So if we lift up the hinge, we can pull the cable out, like so. Now, this is the LiDAR mirror, and I'm spinning it with my finger, and you can see that this spins around. And It says US Digital on it. And it says 50 CPR EM1 150i 12317 Rev B. That's what it says on that disc. So now that we have the back off, let's see if we can get the front off. Really snapped in there well. Let's try the bottom. Better luck with the bottom. As I'm going around, I'm kind of prying up. And here's the front piece. Again, it's a piece of plastic and there's a rubber O-ring around it. So this says Flex PIFA 2.4 and 5 gigahertz. So this must be maybe the Wi-Fi receiver. Here we have the lens, and here's the motor that spins the camera around. So we have the front, bottom, and the back. And again, this also says Flex PIFA from Laird, LAIRD, 2.4 and 5 gigahertz, and there's a wire running into there. Now it's interesting, there's a micro USB and some other connector here. I'm kind of curious now what those go to. What the purposes of them. So let's see what else we can take apart from this. Looks like we have a T10. And we'll take the one that's down here off. Take this one off. Now we have one of the sides off it. And if we flip it over, see we have similar screws. And I'll bet I'm not going to be able to get this off nicely with this in the way. So let's see what we can do here. So in order to get that off, I bet it hinges down a little bit. So we can kind of get it to come forward. Yeah. All right, well, let's tackle it another way. Let's do the side right here and take this one out. If that helps. Nope. These black screws are T9s. Now on this side, this chip here says, well, this board says Matterport. The chip says Telit, T-E-L-I-T. And there's a ribbon cable that's connecting that board to here. And it says on here push. So you push this down and then this comes out easily. Got that out of the way. Now this plate is off. Let's get these other screws out of here. This ribbon cable, which connects the LiDAR camera, you simply lift it up and then it slides out. So we have that out. Now we can lift the mirror out, and it has a ribbon cable which goes right down there. So I will lift the tab on that and pull that ribbon cable out. This connector lifts up on either end, and then the cable comes straight out. So here we have the mirror assembly out. And what I'm trying to do here is get this whole thing apart. Well, let's try to get the camera. Back to the T10. So far, with the exception of the four black screws, all these are the same size and length T10 screw. Now this is quite interesting. This piece on the back of the camera is preventing me from getting it out. So we're going to pause that for a second. And figure out this bottom piece. So it looks like there's a piece of plastic in here separating, there's a piece of plastic separating the rotator from the shell. I'm going to assume it's plastic. Try to be very gentle with this. Okay, it's not plastic, it's metal. And it's actually screwed in, I think. Got it. This is a nut, effectively. We got the nut out. Now we have the shell off. So with the shell off, we can see this cable. And it goes through and connects right here. And this type of connector, you just lift straight up and then the cable will come out. So here we have the camera. The RGB sensor. Ribbon cable. We'll put that aside. And what we're left with is effectively everything else. So a PCB board, and not quite sure what everything is. Here you have the rotator. Yeah, that's it. Curious to see what's in here. Let's take a look. This is going to assume the actual LiDAR itself is this. So we have a mirror, and there's a connector there, and then there's this connector on the back. And this cable goes down and around there, and around to the front. I'm not actually going to take the connectors off of that, so we'll put it back. All right, I'm gonna get some pictures of everything. And now let's put this back together. So now we're going to put everything back together. So I'm going to fish. Through there. Okay. Thank you. I missed putting that back in. Darn it. Definitely. And put that back in the right order. All right. Now, I had to take the case back off because I didn't put that ribbon cable in. And it goes right, it's kind of hard to see, but it goes right down in there. Actually, I didn't have to take this case off to get to it, but I thought I was going to have to. Live and you learn. Now they must have some special tool to get this ring back in place. My special tool is a flathead and a little bit of pressure. Now it's in place. We'll put the plate on. Easy way I can show you guys this. Once it sits in there, you simply press it down. It's really easy. The connection that it makes. The back plate on. And the front plate on, and the lens cap on. And there you have it. It's all back. Back together. Well, there you have it, guys. That's how you take apart a Matterport Pro 3 camera and put it back together. If you found this video informational or useful, feel free to give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel if you're not already subscribed, and feel free to share the video if you find value in doing that. Alrighty, thanks for watching.